This video is going to change the way your dashboard looks in Home Assistant forever. Let me rephrase that. Starting today, your dashboard will look awesome, just awesome, with these animated mushroom cards. Let's dive into this. Mushroom cards came into our lives a couple of months ago, and that changed the whole way of creating beautiful dashboards in Home Assistant. If you're not using mushroom cards yet, then check them out. You can install mushroom cards using Hex. I'm not going to deep dive into mushroom cards today, but I'm going to show you something that might just blow your mind, and that is animated mushroom cards. This is so cool. You can animate the mushroom cards and icons in various ways to spice up your dashboard. But before we start, please subscribe to my channel and hit the thumbs up button for this video. This way you make sure that I can keep creating these videos for you. First of all, I have to give credit to Rice, who came up with the idea and a lot of inspiration for various types of animations. You will find a link to examples that he created in the description below. This isn't going to be an easy to digest video. To create animated mushroom cards, you need to understand how CSS works, and that might be challenging. I will try to explain how this works as well as I can so that you can set up your own animations. And you can also download the code I used in this video via the link in the description of this video below. You can change the looks of cards on your dashboard by using CSS. To use CSS in cards, you need a Hex integration, which is called CardMod. If you do not have Hex installed yet, I created this easy to follow video on how to do that. Check it out. Let's first install the CardMod integration. To install the CardMod integration, we are going to Hex. Go to Frontend, go to Explore and Download Repositories, search for CardMod, click on CardMod, click Download again, and click Reload. Clear your browser cache to be sure. Now that CardMod is installed, we can start by changing our dashboard so that it has animated cards. I already prepared some animated cards and will explain how I created the animations. Again, if you haven't used the mushroom cards before, you can also install these through Hex. You can download this dashboard via the Ko-fi link in the description below. You might as well download and install the dashboard first on your setup of Home Assistant so that you can follow along and alter the code to your needs. And you sponsor me in the meantime. Let's start with explaining the animated chips icons. As you can see, I created 5 chips on this page. A home chip that bounces, a power chip that pulsates, a fan chip that spins, a mailbox chip that jumps around, and a motion detector chip that flashes the motion sign. Let's edit the chips card. Click on the 3 dots in the right upper corner. Click Edit Dashboard and click on Edit on the chips card. As you can see, all chips are template chips. We need to use template chips for this because we are going to add CSS in the YAML code for each chip. If you click on the pencil next to the chip, you won't see the CSS, so we are going to click on the Show Code Editor link. Now we see all the chips that are defined in the chips card. This is still business as usual, but if we scroll down, you see the CardMod line, and this is where the fun starts. Below CardMod, we see the line Style, and after that, the styles for each element are defined. You can point to the specific chip with the code mushroom template chip and child and then a number, where the number represents the position of the chip in the list. After that, we start with HA icon and define the animation. In this case, I named my animation Boing. It lasts 3 seconds and will repeat infinitely. The transform origin shows that it transforms on the x-axis at 50% and on the y-axis at 90% of the image. Now we have to define the animation itself. For this, we create the line add keyframes for the Boing animation that we named before. Within the Boing keyframes, we defined what should happen at certain percentages of the animation time. In this case, we use the scale 3D function that scales our image on the x, y, and z axis. In this case, it scales at 0, 7, 10, 12, 16, 19, and 25% of the timeline of our animation. You can play with the numbers yourself to change the actual animation. The second animation animates the power button. Again, we define an HA icon. This time I called it Pulse, and the time frame is 3 seconds. The animation takes place on the x-axis at 50% and on the y-axis at 60%. Just like we did with the house icon, we define keyframes for the animation that I called Pulse. Now we use the scale function to scale at certain keyframes, this time at 0, 10, 17, 33 and 60%. I hope you already get an idea about how this mechanism works. The animations for the house and the power button do not differ that much. Let's do this for the fan chip too. This time we will only make it spin when the fan is on. For this tutorial I created input boolean helpers for each icon to determine if a sensor is triggered or not. You can of course use the state of a sensor for this too. We start with HA icon again. This time I named the animation rotation. It runs infinitely and a full rotation takes 1 second. To make sure that the animation only shows when the fan is on, I've added an if statement that checks if the state of my animate fan is on. Using this, the animation will only trigger if the state is on. When using a chips card, we cannot use a simple rotation animation, but we have to create a more complex animation. So I've added the keyframes rotation like so. At 0% it sets the rotation to 0 degrees and at 100% it sets the rotation to 360 degrees. So it rotates from 0 to 360 degrees during the time frame of 1 second. The mailbox animation is similar to the other animations that we've already created. I called the animation bounce and I've added an if statement again. This time it checks if an input boolean mail arrived is set to on. If you want to automate your letterbox too, please watch this easy to follow video that explains how to set it up. It makes use of the older menu structure and the Home Assistant interface looks a bit different, but it's still valid. The keyframes for the bounce animation are set so that the icon jumps up and down on the y-axis and rotates a little bit at the same time. Now we are going to introduce a new thing in our animation and that is the polygon clip part. Using a polygon clip part, you can mask some parts of the icon so that that part is only visible. There are various tools for that on the internet. The one that I use is the CSS clip part generator at cssportal.com. First, I download the MDI icon that I'd like to use from materialdesignicons.com, like so. Search for motion sensor. Right click on the image and download the image. Then go to the CSS clip part generator and upload that image there. Then select one of the example symbols and adapt it so that it only shows the part of the icon that you want to show in the animation. Then copy the clip part line to your clipboard that is shown below the image. Now that we've determined the clip part for our icon, we can apply it to our animation. Let's set it up. We start with HA icon again. I named the animation clip. It runs for 2 seconds and will loop infinitely. I also added an if statement so that the animation will only play when motion is detected. If we look at the keyframes for the clip animation, we see that I added just one line that activates the clip part at 50% of the animation. So I've pasted the code that we've copied from the CSS clip part generator in this line. The result is that the whole icon is shown at 0% and the clip part gets applied at 50%, which means that the motion symbol is not visible at that moment and it looks like the animation is flashing. If my videos help you and if you want to stay up to date with my tutorials and not miss anything to increase your knowledge of Home Assistant and Smart Home, subscribe to my channel and tick the bell. It also helps if you post a comment. This way more people get notified about these videos. I need your support so that I can keep creating these videos for you. Oh, and don't forget to hit the thumbs up for this video. This allows me to make more tutorials for you. By supporting me, you also support my work as a music therapist to help people with mental issues. Thank you. Our chip card chips are now ready. I hope you got an idea by now of how you can create animated mushroom card icons. Let's have a quick look at the other cards that I've created. They basically work with the same mechanisms that I've shown in the chips, but they have some extra functionalities. Especially the washing machine automation with the spinning mush is a tricky one. Watch the video until the end to understand how to set up that one. Let's look at the air conditioning card. This is again a mushroom template card. Click on Show Code Editor to see how I animated it. Now that we are not using chips, we do not need the end child pointer anymore. Our card contains only one icon, so we can immediately address the mushroom shape icon like so. We start with HA icon again and can define the automation immediately. This time we can use a default animation called spin that runs linearly for 1 second and loops infinitely. Instead of linear, you can also use ease in or ease out, but I prefer linear in this case. And again, I've added an if statement to check if the air conditioning is on or off. Next, I've created three scene buttons to switch between scenes on my dashboard. If you would like to know how you can switch scenes with a button in Home Assistant like Philips Hue, check out this awesome video that explains exactly how to set it up. The first button spins the icon when I click it. The second button is pushed down a bit, and the third button changes the background alpha when you press it. Let's see how you can set this up. We click on Show Code Editor for the first button. When you click on a card, it gets active, so this time we are triggering the animation when the card is active. For the first button, we are rotating the icon 360 degrees and we set the duration transition to 500 milliseconds. For the second card, we are again triggering the active state of the card. To give this card the effect that it seems to be pushed in, we transform the scale to a value lower than 1 and set the transition to 0 seconds. We are triggering the active state of the third card again and change the background alpha to 0.6. The transition is again 0 seconds. The next set of cards is the light cards that blink when they are on. For these cards, we are using the clip art polygon animation again, just like we did for the motion sensor icon in the chips card. Let's open the code editor for the first card. This time we start with HA icon again. With HA icon, we name our animation Illumination, which lasts 2 seconds and loops infinitely. And I've added an if statement again that checks if the light is on. Then I created keyframes for the Illumination animation. I created a clip art polygon using the CSS clip art generator site, just like I did for the motion sensor chip card, and pasted the code here. At 80% of the time frame, the clip art kicks in, and that results in the light flashing effect. It doesn't really matter if you fill in 80% or another percentage, because the clip art gets activated only once within the time span of 2 seconds. The second light card works exactly the same. And now for the last two cards, the sprinkler card and the washing machine card. The sprinkler card makes use of the polygon clip art, but this time I use two polygon clip arts that alternate. I created a clip art polygon using the CSS clip art generator site first. If we open the first card, you see that I start with HA icon again. I called the animation Spray. It lasts 4 seconds, eases in and loops infinitely. And I've added an if statement again to check if the sprinkler is on or not. Oh, I've also created this really nice video that explains how to set up your fully automated garden watering system. Check it out if you need something like that too. I added two keyframes for the spray automation. The first clip part shows at 0, 50 and 100%. The second clip part shows at 25 and 75%, so that it looks like it's really spraying. And now the final piece, the washing machine. This animation is next level, but so cool once it works. If it's too complicated for you, you can download the code at the Ko-fi link in the description below. We need an extra hex integration for this, which is called the stack in card. So first install the stack in card through hex, just like you installed the card mod integration. To install stack in card, we are going to hex, go to frontend, go to explore and download repositories, search for stack in card, click on stack in card, click download again, click reload, and clear your browser cache to be sure. The stack in card makes it possible to show multiple cards within one card, and that is exactly what we are going to do for the washing machine card. Basically, we are going to show the same card twice on top of each other. The first card will show the washing machine without the laundry, the second card will show the laundry only and will rotate that laundry. For the first card, we are going to use a clip art polygon, and for the second card, we are going to use a clip art circle. Let's open the code editor for this card. As you can see, I defined two cards within the stack in card. Both cards are exactly the same, but have a different card mod configuration. The first card uses a clip art polygon to only show the washing machine without the laundry. I've added some extra code to remove the border that is shown around the two cards, but that's just a small optical solution. Then, on the second card, you see that I added a standard spin icon animation that spins for 1 second and loops infinitely. And I added an if statement to let it spin only when the washing machine is on. The transform origin is the point around which a transformation is applied. I set the transform so that the animation starts at 50% of the x-axis and 58% of the y-axis. And I added a circle clip part around the laundry. By default, the cards within the Stack In card are shown below each other. To make sure that they show on top of each other, I change the top position of the second card to minus 99 pixels. This way it is dragged on top of the first card. And I set the height of the Stack In card to 100 pixels, so that it fits the height of the sprinkler card that is shown to the left of it. And this is how you can create animated mushroom cards. The possibilities are endless. You can see more examples on this site. I am curious about what animations you can create. Let me know in the comments and send me your dashboards on the Dump Your Dashboard channel on my Discord server. You'll find the link to my Discord server in the description below. If you don't want to type the code from the screen, you can download the code that I've created for this video via the Ko-fi link in the description below. With this, you sponsor me and make it possible for me to keep creating these videos for you. I want to thank everyone who has supported me in making these videos and tutorials so far. I could never have done this without you. Thank you. You can support me through Patreon, Ko-fi, or by joining my channel. If you also want to support me, look in the description of this video for the links. With that, you make it possible that I can continue to make these videos for you. Oh, and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and hit the notification bell. I will see you soon. Bye bye.